Welcome to Blackboard Basics for Students. This is a 9-part series, and this video covers taking online quizzes and exams. In an online or hybrid class, students might be asked to take a quiz or an exam in Blackboard. This video will show you what an exam might look like in Blackboard, as well as discuss ways to properly set up your computer in preparation for the exam. In this sample course, exams are found in their own folder. Because the exam may only be available for a limited time, the link to the exam may not appear in this folder until the start date of the exam, and the link may disappear after the due date. If you cannot find the exam, check your syllabus for information about when the exam will become available. As with other assignments, your instructor may set up their exam one of a few different methods. Here, I have some sample exams so I can show you some of the different methods. After clicking on the exam, you will see some of the information about how your exam is set up. In this case, there is a time limit, and when the time expires, you will be given the option to continue the exam, possibly with a point penalty, or to submit. In this case, the exam can be saved and resumed later, but when there is a time limit, the timer will continue to run if you leave the test. Your timer starts once you click Begin. Depending on the settings, the exam might open in a new window or it might open in the same window. Be sure your pop-up blockers are turned off. If there is a time limit for the exam and your computer is set up correctly, Blackboard will show you a countdown timer as you complete your exam. If seeing this timer on your screen is stressful to you, consider putting a post-it note on your computer screen to cover the timer. You may then want to keep track of your time using your own clock instead. For all exam formats, do not refresh the page, use your browser's back button, or close the window. It is important to have a good internet connection during Blackboard exams, and students using wireless internet connections, even strong ones, have reported difficulties. Faculty at Saddleback and Irvine Valley Colleges generally recommend using a non-wireless internet connection to take exams. This sample exam is set up to show only one question at a time. Students must answer the question before moving on to the next question. Many times, instructors do not allow students to backtrack, meaning students cannot go back to a previous question. This may be a very different setup than you might be used to in a typical in-person exam, but many standardized online assessments are now being created this way. One tip is to give yourself a maximum amount of time to spend on any one question before deciding it is best to make an educated guess and click the arrow to move on to the next question. It is not necessary to save your answer, as Blackboard will save your answer each time you move on to the next question. Click on Question Completion Status to see how many questions you have completed and how many questions you have left in the exam. Here we have answered one of three questions. Click again to hide this information. Let's leave this exam unfinished to see what a different exam might look like. In some cases, the exams will show all exam questions at once. Here is an example of an exam set up that way. Although it isn't necessary to click save after every question, you may want to do it every 10 to 15 minutes in order to make sure that your internet is still actively interacting with Blackboard. In an assessment, students might see multiple choice type questions, including true-false, and students may see short answer or essay questions. It is possible to have a mix of both multiple choice and essay questions within the same exam. For a multiple choice question, students should click to choose the answer that they want before moving on to the next question. Short answer or essay answers should be typed directly into the text box. At the end of the exam, you will click to submit your exam. If your instructor allows, you may be able to save all answers without submitting and resume the exam at a later time. Remember that for timed tests, if you save without submitting, the timer continues to run. Let's click Save and Submit. Click OK to confirm your submission. How do you know that your exam was submitted properly? You should see this page as confirmation of the details of your submission. In addition, your gradebook will note that you have completed the exam. Some exams are graded automatically, and your score will appear as soon as you are finished with the exam. Other exams need to be manually graded by the instructor, so you will see either a checkmark or a needs grading icon in the gradebook. Currently, Blackboard uses an exclamation point as its needs grading icon. In contrast, you can see that the blue timer icon next to exam 1 indicates that I left exam 1 in the middle of the exam without properly submitting it. Here are some tips for taking exams in Blackboard. In an online class, technical difficulties are always a possibility. The best way to prevent them is to be prepared. You can do your best to set up your computer in a way that is compatible with Blackboard. For Saddleback and Irvine Valley College students, it is highly recommended that you check the student technical support websites in order to determine what browsers and settings are best for Blackboard. Note that as Blackboard and internet browsers go through upgrades, the recommended browser settings may change. The updated information will be found on Blackboard's website as well as the college student technical support website. Unless specifically recommended by your instructor, you should not use a mobile device such as a smartphone or a tablet to complete your exam. In most cases, Blackboard exams are not compatible with mobile devices. In addition to computer and browser settings, there are a few additional things you can do to help prevent a technical difficulty during an exam. First, be sure that all other programs are closed during the exam, including things like iTunes or other browser windows. Second, a good non-wireless internet connection is best for accessing Blackboard, but especially when taking an exam. Wireless networks have a tendency to go offline momentarily, which you wouldn't even notice when browsing the internet, but will cause your exam to close down. It is important not to use the back or refresh buttons on your browser. If you do so, your exam will be closed and you may not be able to re-enter. If your exam closes unexpectedly, first, take a screenshot of any error messages that might appear. Then, try to re-enter the exam. If it is not possible to re-enter your exam, you should contact your instructor immediately by email with as much information as possible, including that screenshot if you took one. You may also want to check the syllabus for your instructor's policy about technical difficulties. Additional tips for taking online exams, including strategies for studying for online exams, can be found on the Student Technical Support website. I also briefly mentioned some general strategies for success in the last video in the Blackboard Basics for Students video series titled Additional Online Student Success Tips. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps. Check out the link to other videos in the Blackboard Basics for Students series in the general information section below.